Hey, good morning all. I'm today going to present on the robot framework extension side. And my name is Suchita Gatwani. I have 10 years of experience in software development and automation with different domains. I mostly work with the embedded storage systems and data domain also. Robot framework is a generic framework. Robot framework is a generic test automation framework used for the test automation and robotic process automation. This is highly portable, independent of operating system and applications. The syntax of the robot framework is like an English statement like, so it's very easily readable. And it's very easy to start to work on. Robot framework is basically developed in the Python. This is the main positive side is this is open source. It is released under license 2.0. So there is a no cost of using it. This is extensible such as we can integrate with the latest tools. And that makes it powerful and flexible kind of automation software. It has a rich ecosystem and an active community to support. This is the basic architecture of a robot framework. We have data is the test data, test suits. What we use to write the test scripts for the test automations. So that all inputs and configurations are part of the test data. Then robot framework utilizes this test data to execute the target under target system for the testing. And the test data interfaces with the target system using the library interfaces. My slideshow is not working, just I'm reopening it again. The test suits of the robot frameworks are the tabular-like sections, and it is a tabular-like format, and it is divided into the major sections. Each sections are syntactically denoted within the three asterisk marks. So let's look at the what sections these are. The setting sections, variable section, test case sections, and keyword section. And this dot represent our the statements which we will see in the coming examples. So let's moving through the setting section. Setting sections, settings are available in the setting section. So mostly the setting section includes plays the role for importing the libraries, importing the resources, variables. Also, it has a documentations. We can import the metadata configs. We can set the suit setups and suit teardowns and the tags for the test case and so on. Next one is the test case sections. Test case section, in the test case sections, we use these sections for the typical test verification purpose. And we can write the multiple test case under the one test case sections. So the labels available in these sections are optionals, and those are documentation tags. Tags are used as a marker for the test executions. Setups. Through setups, we can define the what exactly to be set up pre or start of test. Then there will be the test sets which we use using the keywords, and teardowns are also there. Templates can be used in the test case sections, and timeout. Some test cases are limited using the timeout by setting the timeout parameters. Keyword section. Keyword sections are similar to the test case sections. Here the keywords are keywords, we can do the analogy as I know methods. So in the methods, the way we achieve one functionality in the keywords, we define the specific steps to get cover up. The labels available in these sections are similar to the test case section, except the return. The return is not available in the test case sections. As methods returns the value, it has the return keyword label. Similarly, we have a teardowns and timeout, as we have the options with the test cases. I miss the variable sections. The variable section, like in other languages, Robert framework supports the variables, and we can define the, we can handle the Python list like variables or declared variables or the standard environment variables using these variable sections. Also, this is not compulsory. We can define the variables inside the test case and the keyword sections also, but common variables we can be used to define with the variable section. Moving ahead, though the Robert framework is the keyword driven framework, it supports the different types of test case style, like a keyword driven, data driven, and behavior driven. So we can use one application, one test case. We can create our test case as per our need in the different test case style. So this is an example of keyword driven. This is an example of the keyword driven test case. Here, whatever is marked in green are the keywords. In the keywords, the keywords are the like enough functions, but here we can define the keywords with the space separated format. So open browser to login page is a single keyword. Similarly, this test case is for validation of the login, where the keyword is used, one keyword is open browser to login page keyword is used for opening the browser. Then input input username will enter the text into the input username field, and similarly the password field. Then submit button click is handled with the submit credential keyword, and validation part will get handled here with the welcome page should be open keyword. And at the end of the test case execution, we need to close the browser. So we have defined the closed browser for the teardown. As like an other test engines, teardown will always get executed independent of pass or failure of the test case. Here, second example of a data-driven test case style. Here we can, the inputs getting vary with respect to the test templates. This example is taken for the data-driven, which data is vary on the valid and invalid username and password combination. Behavior-driven test case, the given when and then labels plays the role, and the keywords are browsing open, browser is open to the login page. Then when the username, the demo, login in which password is more. Here we are passing is an data, and here in the behavior-driven, we passed it as a part of the keyword. And this is a validation where then welcome page should be open. So I will demonstrate the same example using the same example. So this is the same example which we have seen in the PPT. That which opening the browsers, input username and password, then submit the credentials, and then validate the steps and close the browser. So all these here, we don't have a keyword section. So keywords are present in the resource, and this resource is defined in the imported using the setting section. This is an example of a data-driven test case where we are using the template, test template, this. So on this test template, all the data is getting executed with these combinations of the data. and we have defined the keyword section over here for defining the test template. This is a behavioral driven test case that we just saw. Here we can see these keywords are defined in the keyword section over here. And this variable is passed as a part of the keyword in the behavior driven test case. So if you can see, my login test is my test suite, and I'm executing, I will show how to run the test suite or a test case. So we can just simply define the robot and the test suite name, that even works. But I'm just using the extra parameters hyphen L as a debug. The default debug level is info, but I just show the some more informations. During the execution, I'm using the debug mode. And as I see in my project directory, I've created a separate directory for the logs where logs will get loaded. If you don't define the directory, the test reports will get, the output reports will get executed, created in the current path. So so that it will not mess up my project structure, I'm separating it with the log directory. So after the executions, these are the output. Output reports get generated in the XML, log HTML, and the report HTML format. The test case files, we have an option to define the test case file either in the with .robot extension or with the .txt extension. And we can use it also support the two type of syntax. I have used the spaced-based syntax, or we can separate the keywords and parameters using the pipe-based syntax also. Now just let's look into the this is a log output HTML, where it shows the execution log of the test case. So as we have, this is a data-driven test case, which is operated on the template. And this is the input data. So here in the log, we have an options of info and debug variations. So while viewing for the log, we can skip the debug logs. If you want to go into details during the failures, we can select the debug logs. But default log level for this framework is the info. And here we have a report section. It will give us summary reports of the overall execution. If you can see, there are the options. By default, Robot Framework treated it as an critical test cases. So until and unless I didn't define it, these are the critical test cases. I said earlier in the table explanation that we can define the tags. I didn't define any tags. Else, if I define the tag, I will get the test execution by the tags report. For these tags, that means test cases, this total test cases executed, passed, and failure reports. One more thing, that if any of the test cases get failed, then this background automatically turn into the red color, and it can be configurable also. So that's all for the introduction of the robot framework. Moving back to this. So I am pretty much covered this all, that test cases styles and extensions and test reports and log and high level keywords into this. Yeah, one more thing is simple high level and low level keywords. So let's take an example of this resource file has an high level keywords which got used during the test case, but this high level keywords are developed using the Selenium library, which is the low level interface library available for the robot framework interface. So if you can see, that means we can create our own keywords using the low level available keywords. So libraries are the backbone of the robot framework. Robot framework libraries are, we can divide robot framework libraries into the three types because they provide the actual testing capabilities to the framework. So some of the libraries are available with the robot framework itself. Those are known as the standard libraries and like in a built-in libraries. Built-in libraries are, we don't need to import these libraries into our code. This is by default added as a libraries. For the rest of the libraries, we need to use our setting sections to import this. Dialog libraries are for creating the interactive or semi-automatic test execution using the dialog libraries. XML libraries provide the flexibility over the XML operations. OS library for supports the OS tasks. Process library for the multiprocessing. String for handling the string. Date times, remote libraries. Screenshot library, most of the web applications utilizes this screenshot libraries for taking the screenshot at the certain verification. For the connectivity, we have an telnet libraries and to handle the variables like the list dig, we have an collection library. So these are the default library, but as the community is very active, we can see the multiple exclusive set of library supported by the community. We need to install those libraries into the packages. But what happened in the practical world, the products are ranging from different domain to the, from one domain to different domain. Let's an example of financial domain, having the banking, insurance, then manufacturing domain, which use the industrial 4.20 standard or smart manufacturing. There are IoT products, then automotive products are there in markets, cloud and services are there. Application domain, we have a backend, frontend, full stack applications, Android, iOS applications, and you can keep counting the variety of the product we have in market. So to look into the project for the automation, we have the challenges to use this library. And that's the strain that we have a exclusive set of library available and we can extend the library further. So let's take the sneak into how the whole design is. So this is a test data, which I show in the high level language, high level architecture of the robotic framework. So test data mostly consists of test inputs and test scripts and expected results. As I said, device simulations is the optional one. As I said, let's take an example of the automotive domain where actual devices are not available. So those devices getting emulated to set the typical values through the configuration. So such a configurations are needed while the as an while automating those test environment. Configuration files. So configuration files are like a common settings needed for the test suits as well as the system under test. Let's take an example of my current project, which is OCS, that is OpenShift Container Platform. The OpenShift is the product which is supported on the multiple platforms, varying from the cloud to the virtuals to the bare metals. So the test suit for the OpenShift test suit is applicable on all the platform, and some typical test cases are applicable on the depends on the platform specific. So those configuration needs to be set depend on which is the platform under test. So these test data get utilized by the robot framework to test the system under test using this interface library. And what is the challenge that what all the features which is all the interfaces needed for our system under test may not be available with the standard library or with the available external libraries. So let's have a look into the libraries. What are the availables and how we can extend the libraries to achieve the solution, automation solution for our specific project. So I just take random examples for the external library over here just to understand the or just to give the introductions of the existing exclusive library sets. So APM is a library which can be used for the web testing on iOS and Android test. Then we have a databases libraries, varies from the MongoDB, Oracle, and SQL databases. Nowadays, with the Kafka, Elasticsearch, and image processing is getting used. So to handle the interfaces of automation of such a product involving this, we have these libraries. Then to handling the data under test, we have Panda libraries, Excel libraries, OpenPyX libraries, calculator libraries, CSV libraries, OpenPyXL libraries. For the storages, we have an interface, HDFS interface available. Kubernetes is the most common service available in the most of the products. So Kubernetes is a kubelet will help in for the interface of such a product for Kubernetes interface. AWS Cloud is again widely used, so we can automate the test using that AWS library. The protocols like MQTT, RabbitMQ, Serial will get handled to the protocol interfacing libraries, which are also readily available. Web application, HTTP and Selenium, and for the REST API related API testing automations, we have the request libraries and so many. Again, we have the Jenkins and the notification libraries, which is widely used for the integration and for the test automation solution. So what means by this integration is means this solution we can extend further by adding some adapters on it. So like that test case is pure test data can be purely used by the robot framework and can be test the system can be tested using the library. However, to input the test, we can make the flexibility of some CLI utility or the graphical user interface as if needed for the projects. Again, most of the projects are using Jiras for updating the test outputs. So we can add the external interface adapter for updating the notification after the execution of the test cases and updating the test outputs into the databases, which in turns can be used for the updations of the defect tracking tools like Polarians and Jiras and Bugzillas. So let's move to the main core of the today's sessions. That is the how to extend the robot framework by customizing it or by extending the existing robot framework. So I'm using, we can develop, most of the products are available either in the Python interface or Python core or Java core, or if it is not available, it's in the other library. As this framework is based on Python, we can extend those using the remote interfaces. But today I am checking the one example of a Python library code. This is, I'm taking the example of the Azure platform. And I'm taking the simple test where for my OpenShift cluster, after the deployment, six nodes, six VMs will get up. And I have created a library using the existing Python core, which is dot is. This is the Python core which I'm using. I'm just demonstrating the basic functionality to understand. And the test that I'm covering is after the deployment, six nodes, six VMs are created or not. In OpenShift cluster, there are three worker nodes and three master nodes after the deployment. So I have written the one test case around it for the verification. And after the deployment, all the clusters should be in the running state. So I just create one random solution, random test example to understand how easily we can extend the existing Python core into the robot framework interface. Mostly the syntactical way of defining the Python file and the class name should be same. If it's different, then we need to explicitly define the class name in our import section. And if it is not, then just importing the file will sufficient to create the instance of our class. This is one of the most important statement while creating the robot interface library. This defines the scope of this instance, whether it should be for the test case, for the test suite, or we can use it, that instance can persist for the global execution. So for now, I just have a one test suite. So even if I define it's global, this is to make the connection. Okay. I guess now it is visible. Okay. We need to define the versions for the library. As it's changing, we can use this for the updation. And what basically I'm covering with this is just to create the credential, compute client and resource client. To create the compute client and resource client, we need the credentials to connect with our Azure cluster. So this the connections are made using these parameters. So these are the optional parameters which can be which we can pass for now to keep the secret for my company secret. I have make it available in the secret file, and I am updating it from there. So my this is my credential method, which is just checking whether it is already defined or not, and is getting updated from the file. The load service attribute dict is using that file to get the JSON read and populate the required parameters into the SPDict. Now, to create the compute client handle, I'm using the I have imported the library over here, compute management and resource management client, which is the easily available Azure Python core library. So to create the compute client, I'm just simply passing the credentials and subscription ID, which is as per the as per the definition of this base Azure utility. Similarly, I have developed the resource client made easy using the resource management client, which is again the base Azure utility. And now this will act as an low level keywords for when I'm using it from the robot framework. And these are the application keywords for my library, which is a GateVM instance. So before using the GateVM instance, we need the name of the VMs. So this function will help to get the name of the VMs. Here it uses the compute client. Again, this is Azure Core Python I'm using to get the VM list. So this basically nothing but a wrapper on the existing Python core available for the Azure. Similarly, I have taken a demonstration of one more power status. So there, we are using GateVM power status keyword to fetch the status of the VMs. So that GateVM names gives me the VM name list, and the Gate power status will return me the power state of the VM. So these are the simple keywords which is implemented, and this is acting like an extended custom library for robot framework. So I'm just quickly moving towards the demonstration. Here is an example where I write the small test case, verify the total minimum virtual machine count, where GateVM is getting used, and it returns the list, and we are checking the length should be 6. As I said, the OpenShift cluster have the 6 VMs. Similarly, here I'm just checking the VM list for the name which matches with the master and which matches with the worker. And I'm getting that count and validating it across the whether that worker VMs are number of count is 3 or not. And this is for the checking verification for the power status. I'm just wrapping up as. I'm just executing it and will show the reports. My library is in the lib folder, and my test cases are in this manage folder. So I'm executing this Azure cluster verification test case.
Hi, Suchita. I just wanted to mention that we have a 5-minute mark, so.
Yes, I'm just, that's why I'm trying to wrap up.
Yes.
Yeah, so this is the last one. The test case which executed, I intentionally make it fail to show how it will get captured, the details. So you can see there are 4 total test cases, out of which 3 got passed, 1 got failed. Now we are open for the question. That's all for the how we can create the custom library using the existing core Python.
Yes, so should we move to Q&A? Correctly? Yes. Yeah, there is one question. I think it refers to your use of the terminal.
Yeah, actually, I have created it using the sudo, and my login is my own user. So the log directory, when I create a project, the log directory has no permissions. That's why I did the chmod. There is no need of 777, but just for the WSO, I just given 777, nothing else. And for the robot framework, the community is very good. Documentation is very good. We can just go for the documentations to extend the libraries. I intentionally take the small examples to cover up it in a easy way for the beginners as well as the experts. We are now open for the questions. Only one question.
Yeah, there don't seem to be any more. Ah, yeah. Another question. Is your example available somewhere?
Yeah, the first example which I took is available on the robot framework site itself. This is the robot site. Here is the well-known documentations. I show the standard libraries are also available here, and standard libraries and external libraries. And other here is a documentation link for how to create it. And in the demo sections, I take the first example from the demo section itself.